And it's a privilege also for me to be here. Of course, you've done your master within a year here. That is quite an achievement. And it has been, I think, a steep learning curve for you here this year in Leiden. It's quite an achievement, I think. But from the beginning on, you have been eager, you have been determined to do this, to complete this master, to complete it within a year. And I remember that quite vividly from the beginning, because you started in February, which is also not particularly easy, because most of the students start in September. You started in February, so immediately there was my course on the law and practice of international organizations. And I remember you, even though there were many, many students in the room, because you were one of the most active students, because when it came, I remember about the ASEAN Secretariat, I think that was the issue, powers and functions of the ASEAN Secretariat. That is, of course, something special that you bring to the audience, because you have a background already in practice. You have worked for a number of years with AIPA, the ASEAN Inter-Parliamentary Assembly, of course, which is quite helpful if you do a study in international, but you already have some practical experience. So I remember you from the beginning. So I was quite happy that you also decided to do a thesis in a field which was to some extent familiar to me, and that I became your supervisor. So we got to know each other a little bit better in the process of supervising, and for you the writing of the thesis, because you have to do this, of course. This was indeed a steep learning curve, I think, because I can now be honest with you. I've always been honest with you. You remember that, because in the beginning, I think there was still a lot that you should do on this thesis, in particular as far as the general framework on international human rights, and of course a lot to cover, of course, so not easy to condense this in one chapter. So I, to be frank, in the beginning I did not know in which direction it would really go, and I think the biggest challenge for you was, of course, coming from practice and knowing, of course, when you talk about Thailand, when you talk about Indonesia, about Myanmar, you see the faces of the delegations. You know the people involved who have to do it, who have to try to come to an agreement. So the challenge for you is, of course, now you're in academia, in Leiden University, to do the master's, you have to do an academic work, a thesis. So you, by definition, you have to be at a certain distance from this practice. And I know I've supervised other people who have already long practical experience sometimes. This is not always easy, because you know how things are in practice. So you have the idea, ah, these theories in academia, it's not relevant. It's not really relevant. You know really how things go in practice. But that is the biggest achievement, I think, that in your thesis, in the final version I have it here, you were really able, you showed you were able to combine your practical background, your practical experience with the knowledge that you have obtained here at Leiden University about international law, about international human rights law, to integrate the two. That is an achievement, and for that reason, we have decided to give you this grade 8, you know this, for the thesis, which is an excellent result, I think. So I think it's fair to say that I've seen quite a number of students from Indonesia over the many years I've been here at Leiden, but you're one of the best. So that is really, really, was quite nice to see. It's also an achievement because I know you're not only here yourself, but it was a decision, quite a decision, to come here, to travel to Leiden, because you have your husband, you have your daughter, so that must not always have been easy to be here at such a distance from Indonesia, hoping that things at home would be okay. But then there was you went back to Indonesia over summer, and then also later on I saw you on your bicycle with your daughter. You were completely Dutch. You looked completely integrated here in life in the Netherlands. So it was so nice to see you there with your daughter. So the thesis is a very good piece of work. You have learned a lot, and you already had an international background, having studied in Cairo, having studied in Australia, I remember. So you deliberately wanted to go to university to learn more and even go further now, because this is only the appetite. I think you want more, and you now have the idea of trying to find the possibility to do a PhD, and you have an idea to do perhaps about the Rohingya in Myanmar, which is of course very topical nowadays. So fingers crossed that it will be possible to do this one. So in short, because we have limited time, Mr. Chair, yes. Unfortunately I could go on for some minutes, but we're not the only one graduating here this afternoon. in a few minutes, I'm allowed to congratulate you because the chair is the most important person in this meeting here. But I'm very pleased that I could be here to say these few words to you and to share with you that I really have great respect for what you have achieved here this year in Leiden. So congratulations, a few minutes to you and to your friends and family. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much for this very positive report, I must say. And 8 for your thesis is great indeed. So congratulations with that. And after this ceremony, there will be more congratulations on you being master. Are you ready for it?
Of course.
Okay. Are my companions positive?
Yes.
Okay. So let's do it. I'll stand up if you do the same. That would be nice also for the pictures.
Thank you.
So the people taking pictures, they are allowed to move.